So the problem is, find the point on the plane 3x plus 5y plus z equals to 10 nearest to the point 201. So let's start off by drawing this problem out. We have a plane, which is the set of all points satisfying the equation 3x plus 5y plus z equals to 10. We have a point near the plane, which has the coordinates of 201. And we have a point on the plane, which is the closest part of the plane to 201. And we want to solve this problem with vectors. So let's define an origin for our vectors to sit on. And the point vector will be going from the origin, maybe through the plane, to the point. And it's going to have the component 201. And we'll also have a vector that goes from the origin to the point on the plane. And since it's a point on the plane and will satisfy this equation, let's give it the components of x, y, z. Alright, now let's approach this problem. So we know that we have a point that's at 201, and we want to go from that point to the point on the plane. So let's try to connect them with this vector. Let's call it c for the connecting vector. So before we try to find out what c exactly is, we can start off by trying to deduce some of its properties. For example, we know that c has to be a line that goes from 201 to the plane, and has to be the shortest line at that. So if you can imagine, we can draw multiple lines that go from the point to the plane, and want to find the shortest one. So how do you find the shortest one? Well, when each of those lines touch the plane, they will form an angle with the plane. Usually, that angle will be acute, but one of them will be a right angle. And if we form a right triangle for each of these lines, we can use geometry to deduce that the hypotenuse of a right triangle is always going to be the longest side. So the right angle side of the triangle will always be the shortest side out of all of the possible lines. So therefore, our connecting line should be a vector which is perpendicular to the plane in order to minimize its distance. In other words, it is a normal vector to the plane. So how do you find what this normal vector is? Well, being a normal vector, it must be some multiple, let's say k for our multiple, of another normal vector to the plane. So if we can find out another normal vector to the plane, we will be able to know what the direction of c is. Now, how do we do that? Well, you might think about picking, say, 3 points on the plane, which satisfies this equation, drawing two vectors from the points, and then cross multiplying them to get the normal vector. Now, that is going to take some time, so there's actually a simpler approach. And to show that approach, let's look at it in the two-dimensional case. So say we have the line 3x plus 5y equals to 4. And when we graph it, it's going to look like this. To find the slope of the normal vector to it, what we can do is we can find the slope of the original line and take the opposite reciprocal of it. So the slope of 3x plus 5y equals to 4 is, when we rewrite it in slope-intercept form, we can find that the slope will be -3/5. And if we take the opposite reciprocal of it, we'll find the slope of the normal line will be equal to 5/3. And if we represent it in vector form, we can write it as 3, 5, as in it rises by 5 and it runs by 3. And you might notice a pattern here, in that 3 being our x component matches with the 3x in the standard form, and 5 being our y component matches with the 5y in our standard form. And that is actually an interesting property that applies to both 2D and 3D. So, although this method is less rigorous, it's a very quick way to find out the normal vector of a line in 2D or a plane in 3D just by looking at the standard form of the plane or the line. So in this case, our one normal vector for our plane will be 3, 5, 1. So we can write our one normal vector for the plane will be equal to 3, 5, 1. And so now we have one equation for our connecting vector, but we need two to form a system and find out what it is exactly. So we now know what n is, but we don't know what k is. So let's see. We have our vector 201, which goes from here to here. And when we add it to the c vector, we go to the xyz point. And the xyz point must satisfy the plane equation in order to be on the plane. So we can factor out the plane equation with two vectors, so that when they dot product, we get 10. So we can write this as 3, 5, 1, dot product, x, y, z, equals to 10. So you can see how 3x plus 5y plus z equals to 10. And we also know that 201 plus our c vector is equal to xyz. So now we can substitute things in to get 3, 5, 1 dot product of the sum 201 plus our c vector, which is k times our n vector, equals to 10. And we can expand things even further to get, write things here, 3, 5, 1, dot, 2 plus 3k, 5k, and 1 plus k equals to 10. And we can do the dot product to get 6 plus 9k plus 25k plus 1 plus k. All of that is going to be equal to 10. And when we isolate k on one side, we would get, 6 plus 1, that's 7, and 9k plus 25k plus k is 35k. So this 35k is equal to 10 minus 7, or 3. Therefore, k is equal to 3 over 35. Alright, so now we know k. And we can plug k back into this equation to find what c is. And we can add c to 201 to find out what xyz is. So let's do that. So let's see. xyz. Is equal to 201 plus k times 3, k times 5, and k times 1, which would be, let's see, so k times 3, that would be 9 over 35, k times 5 will be 3 over 7, and k times 1 will be 3 over 35. And we add them up, we would get, let's see, so 2 times 35, that's 70, 70 plus 9, so that's 79 over 35, 0 plus 3 over 7, that is 3 over 7, and 1 plus 3 over 35, that's 38 over 35. So that's our answer, that's our final answer. Our point P will be equal to 79 over 35, 3 over 7, and 38 over 35. Thanks for listening. I'm Xing Liu, and I hope this is helpful.